there's a lot of new beginnings for us, including pathways being rolled out to our district. Let me begin by talking about who am I. You know me as a person who is your friend, your ODC friend, or your cubicle mate, or maybe as a very close friend of yours. But do you know me beyond that? The answer probably is no. Let's take a sneak peek on the life journey of mine so far. Let me take you back, maybe a couple of decades, to a winter cold, windy morning of February. On the day of February 6th, the day the star cricketer Kapil Dev was born, February 6th, commencement of my life started. I was born in a hospital in the city of Salem in Tamil Nadu to my mom and dad, who are my superheroes in my life, because they've been with me through my thick and thin, irrespective of what I felt or what I went through. As a child, though I shared my birthday with a cricketer, me and sports were like, you know, a happily married couple. We never got along. Thanks to my breathing issues, I could not play any kind of sport. Because of which, I was pretty much left out during my school days, because we had this thing called this PT period where we used to have fun, right? But for me, PT period was horrible because I couldn't do anything. If I run for some time, I'll panic and I'll fall. If I play something, after a while, I'll sit somewhere because I'm going breathless. That is when my mother suggested me something. If you're not good with sports, why not try something else? Something that does not involve you gasping for breath. That is how, at a tender age of 7, I was introduced to the stage. I was part of my school elocution team since class 3, and since then, public speaking was something that I was always fond of. Because there, you need not run around like a cricket or football. You just have to stand at a place and speak. No big deal, right? No, I was so wrong. I go on stage for my first speech. Only thing I remember is going on stage. Hi. I'm sorry, I forgot what I had to say. And then walk away. But things changed. Seasons passed. Spring came. Summer came. The next year, same competition, I represented my school. And I spoke about how parents are invaluable when it comes to the effort they put into their child. And till today, I stand by that word because they have been my constant support systems. Because of me not good in sports, they helped me carve out another path for myself. I was mocked. I was made fun of. I was insulted in school for being a boy with lenience to arts. Like, how can a boy have lenience to arts, right? Girls are the ones who go speak, who dance, according to them. But a guy being in arts, doing speaking? Dude, have you gone crazy, was the question that I faced. Well, a slap on their face was when I stood first in the inter-school elocution contest that year. Since then, there's been no looking back. Years passed, moved on to college. Finished college, being the nerdy guy that I was, I ended up securing a 7th rank in my graduation across 250 college in under the University of Bharatiya University in Coimbatore. With that, I came into Infosys with high hopes, and I must say, I was never disappointed. Because I got a lot of opportunity to talk to a lot of people and understand and explore what Infosys was. And on one fine day, at a learning and development session, I got to know of something called Toastmasters. I thought, well, I'm an established public speaker myself. Why should I bother? Was what I was thinking. Again, so wrong was that. That day, after joining the club, my first role, I still remember Toastmaster Garima, the timer. I shivered, struggled, stuttered my first word I had to speak. I was struggling that much. But that was the story 3.5 years ago. Speeches after speeches, roles after roles, communication track after another communication track, things have changed drastically. Now, I can confidently say that Toastmasters has elevated me to what I am today. I'm confident in what I do these days. I have faith in myself that whatever I do it with a purpose. Going forward, if you doubt yourself, just look inside you and say, if you cannot, who can? After all, you have to show the world who you really are. Thank you very much.